हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर लेक्चर स्ट्रेसेस इन बीम। मायसेल्फ मिस्टर वाई एस पाटिल, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, शरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, येड्रा। सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट शेयर स्ट्रेसेस इन द टी सेक्शन। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट कैलकुलेटिंग शेयर स्ट्रेसेस ऑफ अनइक्वल आई सेक्शन। सो लेट अस सी वन प्रॉब्लम। A shear force acting on an I section beam with unequal flanges is 50 kN. The section shown in figure. The moment of inertia of the section about NA is 2.894 into 10^4 mm^4. Calculate stresses at NA and draw the shear stress distribution diagram. So before starting the solving problem, we need to calculate actual neutral axis distance. So that's why we calculate y bar for the section. So y bar for the section, now this is the unequal I section. So basically split into this I section into three rectangles. This is the section number one, this bottom flange, section number two, wave, and section number three, top flange. So size of the bottom flange is 130 mm by 50 mm. Size of the wave is 50 by 200 mm and size of the top flange is 200 by 50 mm. So by using this dimension, now we calculate y bar. So y bar becomes a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. Now area for a1 is 130 by 50, that is 6500 mm square. Then area of the section number 2, that is wave, is 50 by 200. So this is the 10,000 mm square. And A3, area of the top flange, is 200 by 50 mm. So it becomes 10,000 mm square. This is A1, A2, A3. Now calculate Y1, Y2, Y3. Whatever the Y1, Y2, Y3 is measures from bottom of the section. This is our reference line. So CG for the section number 1 from bottom side is vertical distance, that is y bar is equal to, or y1 is equal to, depth of the section number 1 divided by 2. So depth of the section number 1 is 50 divided by 2 becomes y1 becomes 25 mm. Then next y2. y2 means CG distance of section number 2 from bottom of the section. So depth of the section number 2 is 200 mm. So 200 mm divided by 2, we got the CG of the distance, that is 100 mm. But that 100 mm from bottom of the wave. But I want to overall or all values from bottom of the section. That's why we need to add this 50 mm. So this becomes 50 plus 200 divided by 2 means y2 becomes 150 mm. Then next y3. Y3 is CG distance of section number 3 from bottom of the section. So this is your Y3. So Y3, first of all, calculate CG for this section number 3. It becomes 50 divided by 2, that is 25 mm. And this 25 mm measures from this point. We want to add all values from bottom of the side. So add this distance, vertical distance. So this vertical distance becomes 250. So 200 plus 50 plus 50 divided by 2, it becomes 275 mm. So a, we know the now a1, a2, a3, y1, y2 and y3. Put up all values in this equation, that is y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. Putting all values in the equation, we got y bar is equal to 166.51 mm from bottom of the section. Now calculate shear stresses values. Shear stress distribution at extreme edges is 0, means at top and at bottom is 0. Now we calculate shear stress distribution at upper flange and wave junction. So first of all, this is the Q1 is equal to SAY bar upon BI. So calculate A into Y bar. So area of that particular section, this is the 200 mm by 50 mm, and Y bar is CG, this is 133.49. Y bar is a distance between, this is our Y bar value. So this is a 133.49 overall depth of neutral axis from top side. So this is the 25. So Y bar becomes 133.49 minus 25, and area is 200 by 50, and width of the section is 200. So this is the A into Y bar. This is the shear force already given in the problem. Then this is the moment of inertia, and this is the B. By solving this equation, we got Q1 is 0.952 Newton per mm square. This is our Q1 value. Now calculate Q2 value. So Q2 value, how to calculate Q2 value is very simple. That is Q1 into B1 divided by B2. So B1 is 200 mm and B2 is 50 mm. So B1 is 200 divided by 50 into Q1, and Q1 value is 0.952. So Q2 becomes 3.808 Newton per mm square. This is our Q2 value. Then next, calculate shear stress at NA, or maximum shear stress, that is Qmax. So Qmax is equal to Say bar upon Bi. Now I want to calculate Ay bar. So for this condition, area is considered for that much area. So depth of the this section is 133.49 minus 25, and width of the section is 50. So depth of the section is 108.49. So basically moment of area is 200 into 50, this is the first section, second 133.49 minus 25 plus 133.49 minus 50 into 50 in bracket 133.49 minus 50 divided by 2. So B becomes 50. So this is the solving this equation, we got 4.41. Otherwise, second method, so this is the second alternative method, that is QNA is equal to Q2 plus Q additional. So we want to calculate this stress due to this particular area, that is additional area. So depth of this Q additional is 133.49 minus 50, that is 83.49, into width of the section is 50. So becomes A additional is 4174. So Y bar is half of the this distance, that is 83.49 divided by 2, that is 41.75 mm. So Q additional is equal to SA Y bar upon B into I. So shear force is 50,000, A is a 41.74.5, and Y bar is equal to 41.75 divided by I is a 2.849 into 10 raised to 8 into 50. So Q additional is 0.06 Newton per mm square. So QNA or Qmax is equal to Q2 plus Q additional. Already we know the value of the Q2 is 3.808 plus 0.6. So QNA becomes 4.41 Newton per mm square. So now this is unsymmetrical section, that's why all values are different. If the symmetrical section, the values of Q1, Q2 is equal to Q3 and Q4. But in this case, the Q3 and Q4 values are different. So we want to calculate these values, Q3 and Q4 also. So now shear stress distribution at lower flange and wave junction. So similar way, we calculated as top flange, same way we calculate for bottom flange. That is Q is equal to Say bar upon B into I. Now area of this section is this 130 into 50, and Y bar means the distance of this area, CG area of this area from neutral axis. That is 166.51 minus 25. This is the 166.51 is neutral axis to the bottom of the section, and this is 50 divided by 2, that is 25. So this distance become 166.51 minus 25. So AY, this is AY bar value, this value is AY bar. Now width of the section consider is 130 mm. Put up all values, that is S, A, Y, AY bar, B into I. In this equation, the value becomes 1.239 Newton per mm square. This is the value of Q3. Then Q4 is equal to Q3 into B3 divided by B2. B3 means width of the bottom flange and B2 means width of the wave. So Q3 value becomes 1.239, B3 is a 130 and B2 is a 50. So 1.239 into 130 by 50, the Q4 is equal to 3.22 Newton per mm square. Now by using this Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and QNA, draw a shear stress distribution diagram. So this is a vertical line. At top and bottom is a start with 0. At junction, first Q1 value is 0.952, Q2 is 3.808, Q3 is 1.239 and Q4 is 3.221 and Q at NA is 4.41. So by using parabolic curve, join all these points and Q1 to Q2, draw horizontal line, Q2, Q3 to Q4, draw horizontal line and all remaining points joins with parabolic curve. This is the shear stress distribution diagram for unequal I section. Thank you.